Hey everybody, what is up? Happy Thursday, and I am Doc Hikari, which means it is time for episode 6 of Let's Play Mega Man Battle Network 1 for the Game Boy Advance. Alright, so I accidentally did something. I went and played the game a little bit to go ahead and see what it was I'm supposed to be doing today, and I know it's the Waterworks quest, so what happened, I got an email from Lam's dad. Hey, that's me! Dr. Hikari. I got an email from Lam's dad saying, sorry I missed you, pal, I compressed the power-up program, and he sent me an HP memory, and, a power-up, which I used to increase Mega Man's charge. Or, no, his rapid, so he fires his buster faster. I'm sorry about that. You know, I did mean to capture that on Let's Play. I saved by accident by sleeping in Lam's bed. Okay. For some reason, I've saved right by the bed. That's really weird. Maybe I just saved by accident, and I didn't use the bed at all? But, you know, carrying on with the story. 1 month has passed since the schooljacking incident. World 3 net crime grows worse, and the damage more serious daily. Peace didn't last long in the town of ACDC. Hey, that's ACDC town. That's the name of my Discord server. But anyway, we got some dialogue from Mega Man here. Lam, it's morning! Come on, it's Saturday! Let me sleep! Ah, you're right. Told ya. But remember, you have weekend class this week. Oh, man! Then we have this little dialogue scene with Lam's mom. Oh, Lam! Morning. Morning, Mom. What's wrong? Not feeling well? No, it's just the water's off, so no breakfast today. What? Aw, but I'm hungry and thirsty. Well, there's not much your mom can do with no water. Yeah, but... Hey, you better get going or you'll be late. All right already. Hey, you're late. Sorry. Lam, did you have water this morning at home? What? You too? Yeah, I couldn't even wash my face this morning. Yuck. You can wash it when we get to school. I hope so. Hey, the pond! What if there's no water at school? Oh no, I hope not. Well, maybe it's just this neighborhood or something. I'm worried. I'm going to go check. So thirsty. Talk to this kid. Ack! I'm late again! And, the last time I was here, I could jack into this vehicle or use the jack-in port on this vehicle that's used for maintenance. So I was able to retrieve the mystery data, but there are actually some cool chips I can get from the virus data that appears in this vehicle. So that's definitely something I want to be grinding for. Alright, and hopefully with that I will get a Sonny Wave chip. I did not. I just got 200 Zenny. And I'm just gonna go for the fast. I know I'm not busting all three viruses with this attack, but at least I'm getting 2 out of 3. And I'm not too concerned about this Sonny Wave Metaur. I don't know if that's like the proper name for it. Level 2 Metaur? Metaur. I remember... Hey, I got one of the chips I wanted. I remember when I was a kid, I used to confuse them with Eddie, but Eddie is actually a distinctly different character from the Rockman Mega Man universe. And, that's something that I've learned, you know, becoming more of a grown-up and, like, studying the lore and just, like, going back and looking at all the games and the characters. Like, I wish I could say I'm more of an expert than I am. I should be for the handle that I'm using. But I do have a real passion for the games and Capcom's legacy of, I did not pick a chip and I did not mean to do that, of just excellence from their arcade games, their 2D fighting games, their side-scrolling shooters, just everything, all of it. To a point. They still make great games with Resident Evil, as far as I'm aware. I've heard really good things about Resident Evil 8 The Village. Sunnywave M, I don't know if I have any M-code chips, so that's not really helpful. I need more Sunnywave Ds. I tried to get him both. I wanted to lure the one in the middle row down, but he might be in pre-attack frame already. No, just hadn't moved yet. You little bastard. That's alright. I'll just have to kill it the old-fashioned way with my Mega Buster. And I got a Metgar G chip, which, it's not a terrible chip. I mean, Metgar is good to use, but I'd rather have a Metgar with an asterisk code, because then it's a lot more versatile, TBH. Oof, this one's just belting me with Sunny Waves. I'm like trying to defend myself. He's like, nah, that's not gonna happen. It's not happening. So there are these level 2 Met Tower virus datas. They appear here, and then there's also, yeah, the Remobits, and I kind of have to be careful with the Remobits, because if I get hit by the shock damage attack that they use, that causes recurring electrical damage to Mega Man, which will stun him as well. I'm not so worried about the stun, but I'm worried about the HP loss. That's not something I'm trying to experience, right? At least not to the point where Mega Man gets deleted. That would be very counterintuitive in terms of the gameplay. Like, later games in the series, you get this thing called a backup. So if Mega Man gets deleted, as long as you have a backup, it's cool! You have a backup! But that doesn't exist in this iteration of the game. That is, like, totally not a thing. Like, I can take a little damage, that's okay, but I'm certainly not trying to get Mega deleted. Okay, so what I'm seeing, the strategy that I should be employing when it's multiple level 2 Met Towers, maybe what I should do, I should line them up and hit the first one with a wave attack, and as long as the first one gets hit, they should both get hit. So I'll just go ahead and launch that. There it is. So that's cool. Brushing up on my, you know, virus busting strategy a little bit here today. That's never a bad thing to be doing in this game, or any of these games, for that matter. So that seems to be the best strategy to use. And for that reason, because I'm busting to try to get more Sunnywave chips with the decode, I'm just gonna go with the strategy that works the best. Like, right here, yeah, I can get two enemies, I still have to deal with the one in the middle. But if I had a wave chip, do the wave, it would have been a lot quicker. Oh, I was hit! Alright, there's one Sine Wave D chip. I really want three, maybe four. That would make me feel pretty good about having them. Yeah, replace a dash. Four would definitely be ideal, but I'm not trying to spend ultimately more than 15 minutes on this, like, part of the chapter, because what I am trying to get to the next part of the game. Like, I'm shooting my Mega Buster so fast, but firing this one. I am happy that I'm getting a lot of Zenny. Why did I just get... Like, I swear, for high ratings, I've been getting 200 Zenny, like, for level 8 and 9, and I just got a level 7. I got 400 Zenny? Man, I'm confused. That really makes, like, zero sense to me. Alright, I guess that's how these things work. So, I've got, like, 3 more minutes, roughly, to try and get this Sine Wave D chip. Alright, there's a third one. I'm gonna definitely try for that fourth one. I almost feel like I'm chasing Pokemon cards. It's really funny. And yeah, just, like, get some of these... Well, I have a lot of K-chips. Time to stack them. What is the least... used letter. I think it's G, but I don't want to take away from G. And then I only have one R chip, and that's roll. I'm gonna replace a regular sword. I think that's my best bet. Because, the sword only attacks one panel in front of Mega Man. So that kind of makes it difficult when you're set up in a scenario like this, where all the enemies were at least one panel in front of Mega Man. And in talking about strategy, I just completely ignored employing my own strategy just there. There's some... Like, 10 out of 10. Like, I ultra-hacked it. I did exactly what I meant to there. Okay, here we go. This should be short and sweet. It was. I got the S-Class ranking, and there's 450 Zenny. So that, I mean, that at least adds up, but not so much... Not so much the 200 in between, or the 400 for the 7. Like, I'm gonna be bugging about that all night now. It just doesn't make sense. You're gonna see me like Charlie Day in the one episode of It's Always Sunny, where I'm just gonna start seeing the numbers all everywhere in front of me in the mailroom. It's meme. It's definitely meme. Alright, and I think I'm gonna replace just a base cannon. I'm gonna organize my chips by code, and I'm gonna get the fudge out. Of this car. I am most assuredly going the wrong way. I have to go upstairs to get Lam to his classroom. I'm probably going to get reprimanded for being late, but that's kind of like Lam's thing. There's the AV room, so go upstairs. I think it's classroom 5B. No, 5A maybe? Okay, it's 5A. And I guess everybody's just chilling. Don't tell anyone I told you, but a kid from B class is missing, and I smell a rat. I should have talked to Dex first. I didn't know that would trigger the event that would start class, but okay. It's a secret, okay? I'd like to begin homeroom. Teacher! We don't got no water at my house! Now be quiet. We're going to talk about that in homeroom. Class, you all know the town water has stopped. What? Miss Mari, do we know why? We're not sure, so we don't know when it will be fixed. Really? I'm afraid we'll have to cancel class for today. All right! Wait, don't walk around too much, you'll get thirsty. Okay. Talk to this kid here. Let's go home. I need breakfast. Lan? I believe he's like asking like, how about you, Lan? Our parents can't help us this time either. They say the chip shop's gonna open today. And the owner is Mr. You-Know-Who. Where? Oh, near the park, I think. So the chip shop, I definitely wanted to talk about it as soon as it becomes open. I am going to be spending a lot of time at the chip shop, especially if I grind in this game. Or I should say, during this Let's Play. So let's talk to Dex. Challenge him. Yeah, okay, let's see what we can pull off. So I'm gonna try and save roll for if he actually hits me. So that I can recover a little bit of health. Wow, I was so close to pressing down during that one turn. Okay, I'll go ahead and use roll now. All I have is the Longsword D chip. And, I really need those panels in the middle to come back because I'm pretty susceptible to damage right now. There we go. I was at least able to damage Gutsman, and the panels are returning. But I am low on health now. So now I have room to move, which is really important when battling Gutsman. Just really not the best hands of chips I'm being dealt. It's kind of just showing off exactly how much I need to improve the flow of my folder, my chip folder. Ooh, I was really trying to pull that off. I pressed A as soon as I saw him step backwards, but it did not go in my favor. And I can't use any of my wave chips. Gutsman isn't close enough for me to use a sword chip, but I can only hope the panels will come back so that I can attack this dumbass with a sword. Yeah, I'm not gonna wait. Nor am I going to hold my breath on that one. Ha! He tried for the guts punch, but I dodged. Unfortunately, that was not my best attempt. You know, Mega Man did take heavy damage. See if I can re-challenge him. He probably won't let me, though. Oh, sweet. Okay, well, I really want the chip that he's going to offer up, so let's try and mess him up. Gutsman versus Gutsman. No, unfortunately, I just get to use the chip. It would be really cool if I had, like, Soul Cross, like, in the later games. I mean, he's really just ruining his own strategy, like, it's not harming me any. Ooh, okay, he actually hit me. Like, he jumped right in front of me and hit me. Now he can't go anywhere, so I'll hit him with the Quake Chip. Like, I sort of did do that. I was gonna say I didn't do anything. I definitely did that. I caused that to happen. I didn't do anything. Okay, that was my fault because I ran straight into the line of fire. If you would. The line of quake. And I'm not talking about the shooter. I wish I had a wide sword. I don't. I have a long sword. It's not the same. So hopefully, he'll jump in front of me. No, it's not. He really didn't, though. Okay. Then I'm just gonna... Yeah! I figured he would have to eventually, like RNG style. And that's exactly why I launched that shockwave there. Oh, can I not? I might have hit him during an invulnerability. Yeah. Invulnerability! So, had I just been patient and waited one more second, I would have actually done damage on top of getting a recup 30. But that's cool, I can battle Gutsman. Like, this is kind of one of the most fun things I can do at this point in the game. You just battle him over and over. Yeah, see, those Sine Wave D-Chips are really coming in handy. They do 80 damage. And they do activate that, you know, post-damage invulnerability frame. But... I think they also stun him briefly just before as well. Yeah, he, like, whips his body back because of it. I'm really not liking those times that I run into his attacks, but otherwise I'm playing pretty well. Well, gee, I wonder where he's gonna go. It is kind of the funniest thing to me, just personally. Like, what if I stole panels when he literally only had two panels to go on? Definitely gonna steal a column, just to be a dick. Oh, it restored the panel too. That is hilarious. So that time, I took 50% damage. But I got a guts punch shit. Oh, no, no, no. I want to battle. I'm trying to get a Gutsman 2 chip. That's what's going on here. Nice, I actually landed both sword hits. Yeah, I got quiet, I was focusing for a second, but nothing wrong with that when it pays off. That's my opinion. If I use roll, yeah, it won't break the panel underneath me. So I'll still be safe from the ridiculousness that this Gutsman, at least for a brief period of time. Of course, those panels will naturally restore themselves, that's what they do. But so far this battle I haven't taken damage. Oh, right after I said, of course. Right after I said. There's just no waiting. No nothing. No warning, no waiting, just wow, to your teeth. Oh, I was gonna go up, but I guess he cracked that panel 100% by using the hammer on it. I was actually trying to move up. He said, no, that is not acceptable. No, okay. What? I could've... Could I? It's ridiculous. He's avoiding me now. So I still only got a level 3. I feel like I did better than that. Like what? I got hit twice? It's a very critical system. It judges you on time as well as damage taken. And I guess overall HP at the end, I'm really not sure about that one. Well, I tried, and it made no difference whatsoever. Just try to slow this dude down for a second. Oh no! Oh no! I took the hit. I did have invulnerability frame after the hit, but unfortunately, like, I'm stuck up in this top row until those panels restore. Wow, I'm getting, like, the crappiest hands here. Like, I guess that's helpful? I don't know. We'll see. I think he's still invulnerable. I think I jumped the gun. No. No, he got hit. I am genuinely surprised. It did not hit him for that much, and it did not do stun damage. That was really weird. Like, my confusion is at its maximum today. Let's just back him up into a corner. It's not exactly how I was trying to do, but that's exactly what I did. So I got my busting level up to 4. I'm gonna try once more, and then I'm gonna progress with the story. I'm not sure how many tries this is. So start off by steel, jump forward twice, and tap A real fast to use that wide sword. And now he's got less space to jump around. And hopefully that sort of gives me more panels to use in an effort to like not get stuck on one panel or one column of panels. Oh right, the 40 damage doesn't do stun to Gutsman, so that's less confusing than I made it out to be a second ago. Yeah. Yeah, that was 100% me. That was all me. I did that. I did the thing that caused me to take the damage. I mean, he can't move, so yeah, he's gonna just use every ridiculous move he's got. Now he can move. He's like, oh, did you think I'd be like that forever? Not really. I didn't expect that to work, the double Sunny Wave, but it actually... It did, and it was really funny. Three for three. So yeah, still a 3 ranking, but, you know, not exactly what I want, but I have 14,000 Zenny now. I do want that. I'm gonna go to the chip store, drop off some chips that I don't want. And, what do I have to do after that? Go to the waterworks, I guess. This is a child I don't remember seeing. I wonder if all the plants will die. These animals will die if they don't get some water. That's very true. Almost everything on Earth survives off of water. And there's a car making suspicious noises right here. Welcome to Higsby's Chip Shop. You want some chips, huh? So he's got Cannony, Spreader K, Recov 80. I'll take a Recov 80. Barrier, Elexord. Elexord is definitely something I want right now. Elexord E. And I guess I'll take a Cannon E. Two Cannon E's. Three Cannon E's. Let's make it a right, nice round. Three Cannon E's. That's all we had. So there's two chip exchangers here, and there's also a Number Man Navi battle machine. Let me go ahead and organize chips by code. So I clearly have the most of Cannon A. I try to do a little bit of variety as long as the game allows me to, and I also try not. No. I also try not to trade in rare chips, but I do feel like it's kind of like what you put in is what you get back, so there's that. Alright, baby makes 10. And I got a Trilance N chip. It's not a bad chip. It's actually pretty cool for this early in the game. Yeah, I have a lot of Cannon Bs. A lot of Cannon As. I don't think I meant to put that one on there. I'm not sure. A lot of Shockwave Ks. Shotgun L, Shotgun Q, Sword S, and I got a Buster Bomb O. That's really cool. I'm not even sure where to get that chip in this game. And I'd like to think I know where most of them are. So yeah, I'm really just getting rid of extra chips. Not trying to get rid of things that I consider, like, super useful. Because I could always get something like an X-Panel. Like, that's totally a possibility. Yeah, I'm basically, like, already I'm running out of extra chips because I'm not that far into the game. Widesword M. Is that useful? Like, sort of? Maybe later in the game? I don't want to trade in any of the Cannon E's. I can do a Cannon A, Mechard A, Cannon B, Cannon B. And, then I'll just feed it the rest of these Shockwave Ks. And that's the last exchange I can do. See, another X-Panel 1L. It's just not super helpful. But I can just as easily get a Blues chip out of the machine. I'm going to battle Number Man once. Just once, I promise. I'm not, dead set on getting the chip or anything from him. Because I'll just be able to battle him every time that I come here. like really not super difficult to avoid taking damage from Number Man. Alright, now he's at half health, so he starts dropping the time bombs. Oop. I thought I had destroyed the time bomb. I had not destroyed the time bomb. There. It required one more hit off my buster. That's how close I was. So, like, at this point, I may as well just blast him in the face with a cannon. Wow! So yeah, I got a 7, and I even got a Number Man and chip, which could be helpful at some point. I did not mean to enter Dex's abode, I just accidentally, like, walked in there. Land, you've got mail! Yai. It turns out that the missing kid from B-Class was kidnapped. Lan, you have to help us look for him, okay? You better help or I won't call your name in homeroom anymore. Good luck, Yai. P.S. Buy some water if you find any, please. So yeah, she calls Lan's name in homeroom when he's late. So the government complex, which I was introduced to be able to go to last episode in episode 5, that's home to both the Psylab and the Waterworks. Since the Waterworks is misfunctioning, or not functioning, Lan is taking it upon himself to go here and find out what up? What happened? And Chod is already here. I don't know if we've met Chod yet. Therefore, check up the Waterworks and net is needed. You're an official net battler, right? I understand. If you could show me your ID card, here. I see. Insert your ID card to use the elevator. The elevator will take you around the works automatically. Thank you. Hmm? What's a kid like you doing here? You're in the way. I always thought Chog came off as a bit of a dick. This is my personal opinion. I think Lan thinks so too. What's his problem? You are a kid, you know. But wait, did you hear that? He's an official net battler. They fight net crime. I've heard of them before. They can net battle anywhere they want. Isn't that cool? I wonder what kind of net navvies they use. Who cares? Let's go check out the waterworks. Sorry to have kept you waiting. Are you an official net battler? Oh, may I see your ID card? If you don't have an ID card, I can't let you in. Aw, oh, man, well... Only staff members? Okay, let's talk to people, find out what is. Bring out whoever is in charge. No milk for her baby. Wonder when things will be back to normal. So, people are, you know, noticeably angry and stressed. Maybe I should find a scientist. Maybe he would have. A scientist or a staff worker. So he tells me to move it along, but, you know, if I don't have any business here. I believe there's a scientist or somebody out here. Drink the river water? No, it's not as clean as it looks. Well, that's not helpful. The nerve of these people! I came to file a complaint, but all I get is, we're looking into it. Oh, people are so pushy these days. Not having anything to drink with lunch is very unpleasant. I haven't had anything to drink all day! I may faint. Well, I am mildly stumped. There absolutely has to be a way to be able to get into the waterworks elevator. Just had to scratch my nose and I bashed the controller into the microphone. Because I'm super professional. Scientist? No help from this scientist. And he talks about the elevator IDs, but that's not helpful because he only talks about the Scilab elevators. He's a very busy scientist, he's just walking around the whole damn room. I'll try telling her I'm not. Oh. Try telling her I'm not an official net battler. Okay, she just says to go over there if it's about the water shortage. And really, nobody here is saying anything helpful. So, usually, when that's what's going on, either the player has to talk to somebody or leave the area. I'm gonna look it up because I don't want to actually leave the area just to have to come back. So, forgive me. It's just... I've already spent time on this and my memory is not telling me what to do. Fireman boss fight. A little bit past that. Okay, that's the traffic lights. That's later. Okay. I knew I had to do what I'm about to do, I just didn't know when. But I guess Yai's email was really a tip. So she said we had to find the missing kid. Well, if you recall, just earlier in the episode, I said there was a car making very suspicious sounds. Is it not? I thought that's what it was supposed to do. Oh, nope, that's later yet. Okay, that's after... Wow. I skipped, like, a whole bunch. Oh, I suppose I can use a Scilab? Lan's dad's Scilab ID? Now, I thought they would be different IDs. Like, I don't think even as a kid I would have assumed that they were the same, but maybe. I sort of had the right idea. I went over to the Scilab, but I didn't find what I wanted to. Gotta keep on rolling on, so I'll get... I guess I already have access, I just have to, like, act like I'm talking to the panel. So, examine the jacket. I'll borrow this ID for a bit. Okay. I would be so mad if my kid did such a thing. Alright, we'll start talking to people, and we're just gonna set up what's going on here at the waterworks, because I'm, you know, already 45 minutes in for today, so this is gonna be a wrap. Just talk to some people. Sure are a lot of kids here today. I didn't see any, but alright. This water cooler is also broken. There was no water inside. the machinery is further inside. Okay, only staff are allowed back here, and I see we have another room full of scientists. Hi, scientist! He's glued to the screen. He doesn't seem to hear you. He's thinking and staring at his screen. What are you doing here? This area is for staff only. AC/DC town's water supply is stopped. Yeah, I know. Looks like he knows. There seems to be a bug in the pump program. We're doing our best to remove the bug. It'll be fixed soon. Oh, okay. It would have been bad if it were a World 3 scheme, but, well, thanks for coming down to tell us. Sure, no problem. As long as you're here, why don't you take a tour? I'm busy right now. Please talk to the boss, Dr. Freud. I just did. Oh, okay, just looking over the guy for the next thing to do. I guess over here by these lockers, there's, an HP memory, which increases Mega Man's max health. I'm not going to complain about that one bit. But we're not going to listen to anybody. We're just going to jack into this computer and, try and fix things for ourselves, because that's the way we handle things. Oh, this isn't... This isn't even the main computer, or like, what I want, my main goal. But 3,000 Zenny. Viruses? Oh man. They are everywhere. Like, these dudes are all over, and they're not giving me much of a break. So now that one is deleted, I can actually navigate and not get blasted by their lances or needles or whatever they're called. So 3,000 Zenny worth of mystery data. Start saying things in the voice of Lokar. Yes, I am Lokar! An old cartoon character you wish you could forget. Oh, Space Ghost. So, I'm not seeing anything else here. I kinda really hoped. But yeah, I'm really not seeing any other points of interest in this small computer area. I also thought it would be a much bigger computer area. There is a Recup 200. Okay. And I got a Tri-Arrow E, which is actually helpful. So that's cool. I will definitely be taking those chips, and I'll definitely be using at least one or two of them. So yeah, I think what's going to happen here, I'm going to start replacing the A chips in my deck one by one, or in my folder. I keep calling it a deck, I know it's not a deck of cards. It is a chip folder. And then just replace lesser recup chips. And now, okay, check the code. So we have three A code chips remaining, and the rest are D, E, F, G, K, L. We have the one L. It's kind of looking really lonely. So I guess I'll add an X panel. instead of the steel A. I have two, thanks to the chip exchange. Now replace that one A chip. I don't see any other L code chips. Oh, there they are. Okay. Well, yeah, I'll use a Shockwave L then. Awesome, that should provide for much better flow for my chip folder. I still need chips to complement the R chip and the S chips in my folder, but you know, I'm gonna work on that as I get more chips. So everybody, thank you so much for watching. I am Doc Hikari, and this has been episode 6 of Let's Play Mega Man Battle Network 1 for the Game Boy Advance. I hope you all enjoyed watching, and tune in next week to find out what happens in the waterworks, how to fix them, and what's going on with that missing kid. I hope everybody has a great day. Y'all stay awesome, stay safe, and stay tuned next week for more Mega Man. Or 2 weeks from now. My worst outro ever. Hope you loved it. Over and out.